Hi, this is Klaus from ODEON. In this short video, I will show you how you can fix a room with missing surfaces using the 3D view in ODEON, and this without making use of an external CAD program such as AutoCAD. Case where you might find this useful is when you've received geometry in the DXF format from an external partner, and this geometry appears to be missing some surfaces and you don't have available the CAD program in which it was edited. So it could be that a few windows was missing in the geometry, for example, and rays would be escaping from these holes. So in this presentation I will show you how you can make use of the 3D view in order to detect holes. So you can make use of the unique edges tool, you can do investigation with rays, you can do 3D billiards in order to see where balls might be escaping from the room, you can use the OpenGL display, which displays a rendered version of the geometry, and then finally you can fix the problems you have found, patch the surfaces using the 3D view along with the ODEON editor. But let's have a look into ODEON and see how we do this. So here we have such a room, and it looks like it's a room with two windows and one door. But indeed there's a couple of windows missing, a door and a window, I think, missing in this geometry. And one tool we can use in order to locate where problems might occur is the unique edges. So I enter the 3D view menu here, which corresponds to the display. That's how always how it is in ODEON. Whenever you select a window, there will be a corresponding menu in the top menu here. So one tool is this unique edges, and another tool we might be looking at is toggle interior exterior. So first let's toggle the unique edges on. You will see, maybe you'll see, some of the edges become slightly blue, indicating that these edges are only appearing one time in the geometry, and an edge only appearing one time indicates that or an odd number of times appears that it is not joining with another edge. We can make it a little bit more visible by toggling the geometry using the T shortcut. So now I hide the geometry, and you can do like toggle. And now it becomes even more easy to see that, okay, there's a missing window here and there's a missing door over here. There's a couple of other edges showing up, and that is because this long edge here doesn't join with the full edge of the walls, because the wall edge is divided into one edge here and another edge here, which might become more visible here. But it gives you a good indication where you have the problems, at least in such a simple geometry like this one. It's pretty obvious. There are other tools you can make use of in order to investigate if you have a geometry which is not watertight, and that is the investigate, 3D investigate rays, and the 3D billiard, and the OpenGL display. First of all, we should be sure we have assigned materials to all the current surfaces. I have assigned 10%, so that's fine, and I know I have also defined a source, so we can do ray tracing. So let's go into the 3D investigate arrays and press the run all, and we can see some rays escaping over here, and you can also see some rays escaping over here. So that's a window that's missing, and it's a door that's missing. So we found another way to inspect the error, the problem with the geometry. Next tool we could use was this 3D billiard, and you can see again that some balls are escaping from the geometry. Indeed, it is the door and it is the window that's missing parts here. So that's another way to look into problems. And if you have complicated geometries, it might not be enough just using one tool. You can use several of these tools, and that might help you a lot. Lastly, we have the OpenGL, which may be a straightforward way to look at problems here. You see these black areas, which is indeed because we are looking at the surroundings outside, which is dark night. And you can say it's total absorption in terms of acoustics. So it's easy to spot there is something here, although we could have a black surface as well. If we go outside the geometry, I just used the arrow key backwards on the keyboard. I can also rotate like this. And there's again a lot of shortcuts up in the 3D OpenGL menu. So we rotate and so forth are options. There are many options hidden there, as you can see. So again, we can see we have some holes in the geometry. So we are pretty certain now that there is a problem indeed with this geometry, and we should be fixing it. So how can we do that in this 3D view? Well, if you press F1, there is a description on how to do that inside the context help, sensitive help. But I will be showing you how to do it anyway here. So what we can do is we can make aid of the mouse here to put some text information on the Windows clipboard, which will model the missing parts. First, we should turn on the modeling options, and then we do that using the M shortcut. It's here, M. Just punch M on the keyboard. That's easier than what I did. Having done so, we can reset the clipboard, and in ODEON, and that's described in the help text. You do that by pressing the right mouse key. Then the Windows clipboard is reset. There's no text on it now. Then we start left-clicking the points we want to include. You can see it becomes red. Red circle, small red circle. So we click 4 points in the perimeter of the missing door. And then I go to the ODEON editor, showing the room geometry. Well, showing the definition of the room. I go to the end of the file. It should be before these three hashes, and I prefer it's before these two block ends. And then I paste the text using the Control V shortcut. And this text will indeed define the missing surface. The number offset and so forth here is in order to ensure that we're not repeating, in this case, surface number 7 and so on. So, and not repeating surface number 1, but it will add sufficient numbers so that neither points nor surfaces are repeated. We go back into the ODEON program in order to catch the last surface, and that was the window over here. Again, I reset the clipboard by right-clicking the mouse. Then I select my points, 1, 2, 3, 4, and go back into the editor, and I can just press the button in the ODEON program, then it will get you back into the editor. And then I paste the last surface. So we paste the two surfaces here, and then we press the ODEON icon inside the editor in order to get back to ODEON with the new revised geometry. Having done that, I will show you a last feature in the 3D view, which can also be used for selecting grid surfaces and materials in other menus up here later on, if you should need that. So I press the M shortcut, and then I get these anchors as you saw before when we selected point, but instead I will press Alt key on the keyboard, and then I will click one of the corners, and that will help highlighting the subsequent surfaces. So here we have the window I just created, and we could do the same with the door over here. So here we have the wall, and then we have the door. So we created two new surfaces, and indeed, if we go into the material list, you'll see that we have two surfaces which have no material reference. I add a material to these two, and then we're done. And just to verify that things are okay, we can go into the 3D Investigate Rays display and do some ray tracing. And you'll indeed see that now we have a watertight geometry. Very nice, no problems, it's been solved. And you can use this 3D tool in order to patch, say, 10 or 20 surfaces. It's not going to take long time if you can figure out where they are. So you might be able to fix some geometries you have gotten from a DXF file, an import from AutoCAD or whatever, without having access to AutoCAD yourself. It's still possible to make minor fixes to the geometry. So that was just about what I I wanted to say, and I can just show that we do have two windows in our a door and a window in our geometry now. It's a closed room. So thank you for taking your time to watch this short little video. I hope you found it useful and learned a little bit extra about the 3D view in ODEON. Thank you.